devastated Alaska has begun the task of rebuilding after the greatest earthquake ever recorded. Anchorage, with a metropolitan population of 100,000 hardy souls, was in the center of the severe shock that ripped down 4th Avenue, the main shopping street. On one side of the avenue, buildings slipped into the yawning fissures. On the other side, not even plate glass windows were cracked in some shops. This department store was crowded with weekend evening shoppers when the quake struck. Here, as in all of the disaster belt, the loss of life was miraculously small. With statistics still being collated days later, it appears that not many more than 100 lost their lives. However, the loss in property is staggering. Conservative estimates make it at least $500 million. Homes in the residential area at Turnagain are tumbled and broken among the fissures. It is as if some giant hand had swept dolls' houses from cardboard foundations. Scientists estimate that the Alaska earthquake was 35 times as strong as the San Francisco quake of 1906 and 10 times as strong as the Assam Egypt temblor, until now rated as the greatest shock in history. Here at Turnagain, guards had a hard time to prevent people from returning home. Home in most cases meaning a pile of rubble. Kodiak to the southwest was almost wiped out. First it was hit by the earthquake, and then hours later, three tidal waves followed one another up the channel and overran the city. Economically dependent on the fishing industry, Kodiak lost 40 of its fleet of 100 boats. The fishing and canning industry in Alaska has been brought to a complete halt. Docks, boats, processing plants, warehouses, railroad lines, they're all gone. At Seward, the seaport terminus of the railway from Anchorage and Fairbanks had 90% of its industry and jobs wiped out. A 5,000-foot chunk of the waterfront disappeared into the bay. Here, the loss of life was minimized by the fact that the tide was low. If the tidal waves had hit at high tide, hundreds or perhaps thousands of lives might have been lost. Although Alaska has been declared a disaster area, not enough federal funds are available. It will take an act of Congress to meet Alaska's immediate needs. Supplies from the other states poured into Anchorage through nearby Elmendorf Air Force Base. Even complete hospitals were airlifted from Seattle. Though the base was near the epicenter of the quake, local damage was forgotten as the Air Force and other service arms turned to the task of helping bring order and relief from chaos. There was little danger of food shortages in the larger towns, but as communications were reestablished, supplies were rushed to remote hamlets. With the courage of pioneers, the Alaskans turned to rebuilding.